Danny Rom, and welcome back to Pokemon Pyrite. I don't know about you, but I'm feeling part 22. So, as you might be noticing right now, our team looks pretty drastically different from how it did before, and I'm going to talk about what I did. So, I got all of our Pokemon up until level 50, and I did this through a combination of grinding as well as going out and looking through some of the more niche, more not necessary areas that are in Pokemon Gold and Pokemon Second Generation that I knew about. And what's kind of funny is the entire time when I was doing it, and believe me, I was looking, I didn't run into a single shiny Pokemon. Except this one. You know what this means. Of all the Pokemon in this game that could have possibly been shiny, you know what this means. You know what this means. We have to catch it first. So, funny story, I was trying to hold on to Dragon Rage with Gyarados so that, specifically for this reason, so we'd be able to catch shinies and other Pokemon that we would want to catch easier without the risk of killing him accidentally, but at the last minute, Gyarados leveled up to level 50 and I decided to go for Body Slam instead. So, just gonna have to hope here, because we're all pretty strong except for Bellsprout, which is laughably the opposite. Give it a Thunder Wave and see what we can do. Pokeball, go! Number one, let's go, let's do this. Not on the first try. That's okay, because we can do better than that. We've got Great Balls, not of fire, but Great Balls. But the ball was blue and the Krabby was blue! I'm not gonna step up to the Ultra Ball yet. Desperate times call for desperate measures. We're not desperate yet. I don't like that it's only given one bobble though. Alright, one more Pokeball. One more Pokeball. Okay. So now we have to get creative. What is an attack that would realistically not KO this thing? How about Sid's Quick Attack? We're gonna give it Sid's Quick Attack. Also, Sid is a Typhlosion now. Sid's Quick Attack. Alright, alright. We have a chance at this. We have a chance at this. We're over leveled, but we have a chance at this. Let's go with one more Sid's Quick Attack. And no more. It's all about the Great Balls, not of fire, but hopefully of luck. Yes! You know what this means. I gotta say it. Give it the Crab Hammer! Shiny Krabby, down. Catch you on the flip side. And in fact, it does have the Crab Hammer with which to give opponents. Really cool. Absolutely perfect opportunity for us. So, where were you training, Danny Rom, that you were able to capture a Krabby of all things? Well, as I was saying, I did a lot of the more niche areas. I walked through Mount Mortar a little bit. I went around, collected a bunch of those items that were there, and that ended up being a pretty good place to train. I went up to the Lake of Rage and that did a couple of the other stuff that was there. I found a miracle berry tree as well as a gold berry tree that Crystal had hidden in the game. Very nice. The gold berry tree was near the route above, well, it was on the route above Goldenrod City. You just surf to the left and then you get the gold berries, which restore 30 HP instead of 10 HP instead of regular berries. But enough about that. What you guys really want to see is what happened to this team. We have Sid the Typhlosion, not the Quilava anymore, the Typhlosion, same moveset as before. Jolteon, unfortunately, still did not learn Flamethrower. Jolteon didn't learn Flamethrower, nor did it learn Thunderbolt, the latter of which it had a realistic chance of learning, but it did learn Pin Missile instead, so I kept that instead of Quick Attack, because we're like the fastest thing alive anyway. Houdini the Kadabra, Psybeam, Thunder Punch, Recover, Ice Punch, perfect moveset, fine with that as it is. Gyarados the Gyarados? So, this is interesting. I went back to Ecruteak City to the Game Corner guy who teaches Pokemon their so-called ultimate moves, which Jolteon's is Rage instead of Thunderbolt. I don't know, whatever. For Gyarados, it was going to be Double Edge. So I thought that was a good idea. I had it learn Double Edge because look at that attack stat, 151. It's crazy. I think that Double Edge generally does more damage than Surf does, so definitely worth keeping in mind. It learned Body Slam at level 50, which I kept instead of Dragon Rage. Fortunately, we caught the Krabby anyway, but Body Slam is just a nice, good, fully accurate no recoil attack for when we need it. Rick Astley the Haunter. Oh, the other reason why I had Garatu learn Double Edge is because before with just Surf and Hydro Pump, we're gonna run into Pokemon that are Water and Ice type in Price's Gym. If Garatu is in, then we would pretty much have to switch out and deal with whatever shenanigans give him the upper hand, but at least with Double Edge, now we can attack it for real. That was part of my logic in doing that. Rick Astley, Shadow Ball is coming into play pretty big. Machoke, I brought back into the party because I think that Pupitar, as great as it is, was kind of a liability for this gym. Again, with all the water and ice type attacks, Pupitar wouldn't have been able to deal with that too well. So I brought it into the daycare. I also brought Geodude, who is not Geodude anymore, who is Graveler, into the daycare as well. And they probably grew levels by this point. I wasn't expecting them to evolve at level 30 anyway, or level 50 anyway. So I think I'm good to go. Team's at full health. Items, I went back and got a bunch more fresh water and lemonade, as well as our two miracle berries and two gold berries that I had mentioned before. We have a max ether in case we need it. We have a PP up that I just found. Also, I went and got the EXP share. I went and got the mystic water. I did a whole bunch of those little side quest things. So, Price's Gym, here we go. Oh, great. There's gonna be a new puzzle that I'm gonna have to figure out. Watch me do really terrible at this. I guess let's have Mario be our lead hitter. I got a bunch of revives anyway, just in case, but the goal is to get through these trainers without letting a Pokemon faint. Alright, how's it going, guys? This gym has a slippery flora. You don't say. It's fun, isn't it? But hey, we're not playing games here. No, you guys are trying to defeat me. Border wants a battle with a Dewgong, so I knew that it was going to be a Water Ice type. Level 45! Not feeling it. Unfortunately, Thundershock is a 3-hit KO, and that Ice Beam is also beyond a 3-hit KO, it seems. So that's a fair enough trade, I guess. That's a significantly less fair enough trade, I suppose. Let's switch into Machop and let our skills show off. The daycare had Machoke learn Cross Chop instead of Low Kick. I didn't realize that Cross Chop only had 5 PP in this game, which is kind of lame, and it's still not fully accurate, so I kind of wish we had Low Kick still, but anyway, let's hit it with the Vital Throw. Vital Throw is our 100% fully accurate fighting type move. The unfortunate part about it is if we use it, then we're always going to go second, so good thing to keep in mind. Machoke is kind of slow anyway, so we'd probably go second to begin with. I fought a Cloyster earlier, and I know we are slower than Cloyster, so I have no problem using Vital Throw here. Cloyster has a ton of defense, so it still doesn't KO, but that's alright. We're gonna do some decent damage to it. This is exactly, well, not getting critted, but this is why I brought Machoke back into the lineup. I think that the fighting type really gives us an edge for this gym. It's 4 times effective on Sneasel, but I think Sneasel's gonna go first, so I don't wanna do anything here. I think it's gonna be very good for this gym specifically, and it's also nice to have a bit of a diversity of types instead of having 2 rock ground types. The interesting thing is, now with the 2 that are in the daycare, that means we have 8 Pokemon that we can kind of rotate between. Graveler isn't entirely trained up like the other ones are, but still, 8 Pokemon is pretty good. Their way to fight prices on that side. Let's check out these trainers. My compulsion is always to beat all the trainers. I think we'll have to anyway. So we'll see what happens. Yeah, I can't believe that I didn't bring Ice Heals. Oh well. I mean, we can't really use them anyway. Hey, Jolteon versus this rival Vaporeon. It's not like we can really use Ice Heals anyway in the fight, but it's a pretty common sense thing to bring for right now. Aurora Beam is fine. There we go. Once we get Thunderbolt, I mean, Jolteon's gonna be golden. Just hoping for that day. Hoping it comes sooner than later. Dewgong, let's go into Machoke again. Growl, really? You must have predicted us. Hit it with a cross chop this time. Oh, goes first and uses Ice Beam. Even despite that, the growl actually prevented us from KOing there. So well done, opposing trainer, but you have been thrown vitally out of the ring. Skier was defeated. No, you made me wipe out. You're just kind of standing still. I don't know how you can possibly wipe out, but whatever. So healing up. Okay, I'm just burning through these fresh waters here. Haven't had to use a revive yet, so let's hope that it continues to stay that way. Tentacruel has a pretty high special defense. We don't really have much to deal with Tentacruel well that prevents that. I think I'll stay in with Mario. Let's see what a Thundershock does. Negligible. Well, now it has a high physical defense too, so we might as well keep it going. Alright. That's what I like to see. Mario growing to level 51, learning Thunderbolt, nope. Octillery. That's not a nice Pokemon. I'm cheating here, just because a lot of ice types are also water types, doesn't mean you can cheat and bring water types that are not ice types. Cloyster again. That's gonna be a problem Pokemon to deal with, I imagine. Oh! Almost KO'd it with the Thundershock. Surf is gonna hurt. Ah, critical hit. I don't know if we would have lived that or not, but I guess we'll have to use a revive now. So that's fine. There are 11 of them. Just rather preserve money if we need. What is Price's secret, man? The secret behind Price's power, he meditates under a waterfall daily to strengthen his mind and body. I don't think that would help me personally, because I get bored easily by meditation and by anything that is not multicolored and flashing in front of me, but good to know. Alright, how's it going? To get to Price, our gym leader, you need to think before you skate. Alright, Skier was defeated. Would not lose to us in skiing. Yeah, that's probably fine. The only time I went skiing, I nearly got a concussion, so you can beat me in skiing all you want. Alright. Well, there are a lot of water types around here, but I think we fought most of them, so I'm gonna try leading with Sid for the next battle. Let's see how that goes. Who didn't we fight yet? I'm not thinking before I'm skating. Interesting. Okay. So here, 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 up. He'll freeze my Pokemon so you can't do a thing. Darn, I could not do a thing. Okay, healing up. Alright. So now we're at Price. I'm gonna heal up all the way because we're at Price, even though it seems a little silly. Alright, Nick, we're bringing a secret weapon. So just for this one fight, I had Houdini forget Ice Punch, we can get it back later, and learn Fire Punch instead, that we had bought a really long time ago. Hopefully it's going to pay off. I'm gonna let Houdini lead because I don't trust Sid in the lead, and I don't trust, I think we'll need Machoke for later. Here we go! Pokemon have many experiences in their lives just as we do! Price, too, has seen and suffered much in his life. Since Prices are older, let him know what we mean. I have been with Pokemon since before you were born. Do not lose easily. Well, did he just call himself the Water Trainer? That might have defeated the point of using Fire Punch instead. But okay, Cloyster we can deal with. We got our Thunder Punches on our side. Fists of Lightning! That's what we like to see. Vaporeon. We have Fists of Lightning again, or we can let it be the grudge match of Eeveelutions. Or we can go to Garatoo and resist stuff. I think Flareon has a stronger defense than special defense, so not inclined to do that option. Let's just let Houdini stay in and deal with it. I don't think it's going to have anything physical anyway. Bite, we don't like that at all. Critical hit Bite, we really don't like at all. I can play the recover game. I'm gonna try that once. Fight! Okay, I don't want to play the recover game anymore. Let's go to Garatoo. Get that Intimidate off. No, it doesn't matter. Fight! Alright, I say double edge. Oh, I shouldn't have said double edge. That's gonna, deal us a bunch of recoil. Aurora Beam is neutral, so we can deal with that, and Body Slam to finish it off. This is why I'm really glad that I taught Garatu double edge, and Body Slam helps as well. Okay, what's next? Price with a Lapras. I was kind of expecting Lapras, to be honest. At level 51, that's gonna be his heavy hitter. I wish we had a Toxic or something like that to deal with it. Options. We can hard switch to Machop and expect an ice attack, and I think that's likely, so here we go. Thunder! Goodness gracious! Okay. Now I see what kind of game you're playing. I'm gonna go Vital Throw for the safe accuracy move. Confuse Ray. Gave the wrong Pokemon a Bitterberry. At least we got the gold berry. Do I switch out? Nah, I think we gotta go in. Ice Beam now. That's resisted. That's not resisted. Oh, goodness. Well, Machoke wasn't exactly a good player there. Yikes. Jeez, Thunder. Mario, I guess. Let's hit it with the Thunder Wave, so that'll help our slower Pokemon. And we can get chances of paralysis. How much does Thunder Shock do? About a 5-hit KO from this point. Confuse Ray, I think Mario does have a Bitterberry? Nope, Mario does not have a Bitterberry. Okay, what has a Bitterberry? Rick Ghastly should have a Bitterberry. And I don't think that there's anything that Rick Ghastly particularly dislikes, so let's go with that. Fully paralyzed. Oh no, it is leftovers. I say curse this. I don't like this Lapras at all. It is his heavy hitter. I don't feel too terrible about that. I do feel terrible about that we only have a few Pokemon left, but I'm gonna try stalling it out with the recover game here. Come on, Houdini. Live it, live it, live it, live it! No! Oh goodness. Mario! Didn't I curse you? Oh boy. Alright. One more should do it, and that will be it. That took a lot out of us, though. I wish we still had Kadabra. Didn't even get to use our Fire Punch. There's Piloswine. I wish we had Machop. Alright, predict the ground type move, switch to Garatu. Don't you dare use Ancient Power. Yes, he did use Earthquake. Alright, do we Surf or Hydro Pump? I think let's go big. Oh, it wasn't big enough. Icy Wind? Okay. I'm okay with that. Oh no, it goes faster! What? Alright, alright, alright. We missed with Blizzard. That, I believe, is four Pokemon down. Maybe we can win this still. Dewgong. Level 46. Okay, that's one of his weaker ones. We still have Sid left. I think his last Pokemon is going to be a Sneasel. Alright, is it worth preserving Garatu? I think it is. I think let's switch to Mario so that way he doesn't have that speed reduction anymore. Ice Beam's gonna hurt. Not as terribly as it could have. Goldberry actually coming into play here. I don't think that there's much of a need to Thunder Wave it, because everything should be faster than Dewgong, unless he uses Icy Wind or something. Okay. He uses Icy Wind or something. Well, you know what? You're still slower! You're too slow! Ice Beam. Alright, let's get one last Thundershock off. And we go down, but we've done our part. Alright, Sid at full health and Garatu. If his last Pokemon is a Sneasel, we're in good shape. If it's not a Sneasel, I hope we're in good shape. We could be in potentially awful shape. It is a Jinx. I think we're in good shape. Okay, let's double edge. Psychic, oh goodness. All right, let's go. Yes! Wow, that looked awful. for a long time. I thought we were screwed. I don't even care that we don't get experience from the Jinx. Yes! Oh. Wow. That did not play at all how I thought it was going to play. I'm glad to be worthy of this badge. Always thrilling gym matches. That brings us at 5-1 for my personal gym matches, not including the one that was the BS 3 flinches in a row. That is a much better record than LeBron James has in the finals right now. How's it going, guys? Price is something, but you're something else. That was a hot battle to bridge the generation gap. Indeed it was. Indeed it was. Thank you guys for watching. I'm Danny Rob of Friendship Playthroughs, and have a good day.